began after the final farewell show. After yet another empty room, the singers stormed off home. Had there really been no worth to what they'd done? Well, then the cornet player whispered in the ear of the trombone. He said, remember when we started playing shows with our cabal? We'd get a decent turnout at that place by the canal. And the crowd was always gathered by that man, the one who almost seemed to force them into giving us a hand. Then the snoozing young bassoonist felt his ear begin to twitch. He said, you know what happened to that guy? They found him in a ditch. Oh, they were the fae, they were the fae, they were the fae red man of a dead man. Yeah, they were the fae, they were the fae, they were the fae red man of a dead man. Now the trumpet stood before them all to share what he had heard. Apparently he lived a life completely without care, and he'd consume his drink with such alarming zeal. And he smoked a pack of cigarettes along with every meal. The dancer said by 25 his heart began to fail. The fiddler could confirm his daily habit of cocaine. Oh, his chest pain was so common, said the bass, but that he always had to carry aspirin with him just in case. Then the blues are cleared his throat and solemnly said that his often quoted motto was correct when I'm dead. For they were the fae, they were the fae, they were the fae red man of the dead man. Yeah, they were the fae, they were the fae, they were the fae red man of the dead man. The drummer could recall that he got worse towards the end. They had all tried to stop him from his mother to his friend. Sat in silence until later on the bus, when the writer said, how did this man identify with us? The accordion played a broken chord and spoke, but he said, I don't know, maybe it was something that we wrote. At the station, as they said their last goodbyes and parted ways, there was a feeling.